Hello, everyone, and welcome to Try This at .work. My name is Kelly Cleland, and I am a customer success manager at Microsoft and a Try This at .work leader. I'm also joined by my partner in crime, Scott Rendell, who is also on with us. He's a partner technical architect and also a Try This at .work leader. So just really quick before we get started, as you all know, a few housekeeping items that we always have to start with that we're required to. So just to let you know, this is a public live event, so we don't capture registration. We're not asking you for your information, even if you're authenticating through Office 365. We are in no way, shape, or form, even if we might have your email address, leveraging that data in any way. Your privacy and security is of the utmost importance to us. As always, please feel free to submit your questions in the Q&A pane, which, again, I'm only human. I realized on the last event that the Q&A pane was not enabled after the event, so apologies for that. It is there for you today to ask your questions, so please feel free. Scott will be monitoring that throughout the event. And just a couple of notes. So you're seeing we do have the upcoming event schedule that's been posted. A couple of those are out on the Try This at .work site, but we did add the third one there. So on April the 22nd, it's actually going to be a double-decker event. So it's going to be a one-hour event. First 30 minutes is going to be covering all of the new meeting features. So those that have been released and those that are getting ready to roll out. And then also we're going to be talking about video optimization for PowerPoint. That's been a big sticky point for a lot of our customers lately. So Scott is going to be actually leading both of those sessions. So really excited to have him speak to both of those because they've been big ask of our other customers lately. On May the 6th, we are going to be doing a session on Microsoft Viva. So we're actually going to be talking about all four of those employee engagement modules. And we will answer your questions, of course, as you all are probably aware of any conversations that you've had, you know, with Microsoft about the Viva modules. We are still working through some of the details. We're not going to be able to answer any like licensing or cost specific questions for a couple of the paid modules. But what we can do is provide you with the information that we do have and show you how we are helping our customers drive employee engagement, which is especially critical right now at this time. And then the session on 520, which I messed up again on the last event. Again, only human. But this is actually where we're going to be showcasing our new Teams features. So this will be a complete showcase of everything new that's been released or that's getting ready to roll out again. So we've done this before. You all love those. So this is not going to just be, we're going to be talking about meeting features, you know, a month earlier during April 22nd, but on May the 20th, we're actually going to be covering all of the new features because we've had quite a heavy roadmap and there's a lot that should be rolled out by that time or getting ready to roll out into June. So we want to highlight all of those amazing features and make sure that everyone has the awareness around those and is ready to start using them in their organization. All right, so with that, I'm going to go ahead and just roll right in here. So today we're going to be talking about pinned apps and how to automate your day. So pinned apps, this is going to be a really short conversation. There's really not much here. First thing that I just want to cover, and this is as technical as I'm going to get on this session today, is just going into the app management. So going into the Teams admin center and for those IT folks, understanding and business folks, how you can actually put controls around the apps, pinned apps in terms of what users are seeing, policies for apps, what your organization can and cannot have access to. We're briefly going to go look into the admin center just to show you those controls. You can see where they are and what controls you do have available to you. But then we're actually going to roll right into, right, today's all about you. And so it's about customizing your left rail specifically for you, thinking about what apps you should consider, and then customizing your team's experience for you specifically from a left rail quick access perspective. And then what's very complementary is then talking about, okay, so we're talking about pinned apps. Now let's talk about how we can automate our day to benefit us, to give us time back. So we're going to be going to quickly walk you through getting started with Teams and Power Automate, talking to the triggers and actions, and then we're going to do a demonstration. So there's already templates, many of them that exist out there. Any of you that have attended the prior sessions have already seen a preview of that when we briefly showcased in past sessions, but we're actually going to do a walkthrough of setting up four of those Automate templates tied to Microsoft Teams, of course. So again, I highlighted there, this is the easy button. Using these templates is a great way to get started. They're extremely simple to set up, as you're going to see. And it's a great way, again, to give yourself time back in the day, which we all obviously never have enough of. All right, so with that, I'm going to go ahead and just get started here. All right, so we are going to get started here. Ooh, looks like I got a refresh. Oh, I logged in. Okay. All right, this is my mod administrator. Give me one second here. It's forcing me to log back in. All right, here we go. Okay, so I'm just logged into the mod administrator account again, but I actually am going to show you when we get into Power Automate, just some of the from an Automate perspective and from what, again, as we're talking about Power Automation and we're talking about flows specifically between users, you're actually going to see what that looks like. Okay, so first things first, I actually want to go into the admin panel. So let me just refresh that. All right, so specifically, I'm going into the Teams admin panel. So give me just a second for this to load. And again, this is where we're talking about apps. All right, so here's my Teams admin panel. Close out of these other guys. All right. So over in this left-hand panel, so this is the Microsoft Teams admin center. Essentially, this is where your Teams administrators are essentially managing all the policies and what folks and how your Teams environment is configured and who has access to what. And specifically, what we're going to talk about in terms of accessing today is around apps. So there's four different options here that you have under the Teams apps for management. So you have obviously ability to upload in any apps. You have the ability to change the status for based off of all the apps, obviously, that are available to you within the app store. Is that allowed in your organization? Is it not allowed? Is it published? Is licensing required for that specific app? Is there certification attached? Again, for those, all of that information is actually out. If you search for it, you can, especially third-party apps, there does require you to go through a publishing process. So just quick note on that. But org-wide settings, if you click into that, so basically, these are your settings. Am I allowing third-party apps in our organization? Allowing any new third-party apps to be published into the store by default? Are we allowing for any custom apps? So for examples, if you know somebody in your organization creates a custom app, are you going to allow that? So those are your org-wide setting options. And again, I'm not going into these in any detail. It's just more of an overview really quick as we're talking about apps. So your app permission policies, obviously there's always a default, which is the global default. So Microsoft apps. So in this case, these are the Microsoft apps. So when you think about Microsoft, right, you're thinking about, you know, the calendar and your files and all that good stuff. So these are, you can essentially say, I'm going to allow all apps. I'm going to allow specific apps and block others. Block specific apps and allow all others and block all apps. So essentially you're defining what it is that your users have access to. The same thing goes with third-party apps and the same thing goes with custom apps. So this gives you a lot of control in terms of, again, from an end user perspective, what is it that I actually have access to? And clearly you can give access to certain people and not to others. But again, this is just from a global perspective. Those are your permissions. And of course, you could create additional permissions for a different types of groups of users if you wanted. From a policy perspective, okay, so you can see here, so how apps are available to a user within the specific Teams app. So we just talked about this, so making them available to specific users. So maybe you have, you know, frontline workers, and they need to have a specific set of apps available to them. You know, maybe your global org-wide is your default. You never actually want to change that. You just want to add a new policy and then assign, you know, what's needed. just as a best practice. But basically, you know, you can click into any one of these at any point in time. And obviously, you can see that these are controls specifically for the frontline worker. So are they allowed to upload custom maps? Can they pin, right? So are they able themselves to pin to the left rail apps that are important to them? In that case, this is on. We always encourage this. It's a best practice. Everybody works a little bit different in a lot of cases. So I think it's good to allow for the user pinning for what's most important to them. And then of course, down here is where you have your standard set of pinned apps. So these are essentially what these frontline workers are going to see when they open up their version of Teams based off of the policy that's been defined for them. And of course, you can, you know, you can move these up and down, as you can see. You can move these around. You can add additional apps to these. You know, if they need access to something else, like a third-party app that can be pinned. So essentially, again, you're controlling what these different types of personas within your organization have access to. And then, of course, the last one is you can customize the App Store. It's more about just, you know, adding in, layering in some branding for your company, you know, adding a logo, a custom background, maybe, you know, selecting a color for your organization, you know, like we'd pick like a Microsoft blue. So again, just allows you with some branding options. So that's all I'm really going to cover from a Teams admin perspective, from a app policy and pinning perspective. So now what I want to do is show you, so you can see here, I have a number of apps, right, that are available to me. And some of these, right, I've pinned already. So you can see like Yammer Communities, it's giving me the option to unpin, which means Yammer is really important to me. I actually pinned this. This HR FAQ bot, you know what, maybe I'm kind of good, pretty seasoned at this point. I don't really think I need this one. I'm just going to unpin that. And then from a, you know, just because we're going to be heading there next, I'm actually going to go ahead and put the Power Automate up here, this app, I'm going to search for that. And then I'm just going to go ahead and, again, right click, and I'm going to pin it because we're going to go there next. So it's going to be a nice little segue. So, you know, the way that you need to think about this is a best practice. So literally everyone, and right, sometimes when I'm talking to my customers, they don't even realize that you can, you know, obviously in the cases where they are able to modify their left rail and pin apps, which again, we highly recommend. But, you know, when they're able to do that, they didn't even realize that they could do that. So sometimes I'll get on the phone with the customer and they're like, I don't understand, like this, I keep adding this app and then it keeps going away. And then when I tell them, hey, you know, you can actually just right click on that and you can pin it, they are thrilled. So just know, right, that I don't think it's common knowledge to everyone, which is why we wanted to make sure to highlight it on today's event. And then the way that you want to be thinking about your left rail, you should literally have pinned to the left rail what you do most often throughout your day. So clearly for a lot of people, especially I think in the corporate environment, it's chatting, it's your Teams, it's your activity notifications, potentially your files, depending again how adopted you are. If you're a really heavy Yammer community user, yes, you should absolutely pin the Yammer's community app. If you are using a, right, so for example, like if I'm in IT and, you know, I'm a part of help desk, you know, you've got the Now virtual agent, or if you find yourself submitting a lot of help desk tickets, pin the Now virtual agent, just for as an example. But you, again, think about, you know, for people in marketing, for example, I just have this up, so I'm just going to talk about what's here. I'm not picking any because there's preference. But like, for example, Adobe Creative Cloud, right? We don't just allow for our types of files, right? We want you to work in the way that's best for you. So, right, folks in marketing, specifically in maybe in the design department, they may have Adobe Creative Cloud pin because, right, they're, you know, maybe they're one of the designers and that literally is their day-to-day. So think about how you work, pin what's the most important to you and have it easily accessible and at your fingertips. So that is honestly all I'm going to cover from a pinned app perspective. That's really it in a nutshell. There's not really that much more to it. Obviously, if you have questions, please feel free to submit them into the Q&A window, but we're just gonna move right on because I think what's really exciting about today's session is Power Automate. So obviously you can see that there is a Power Automate app. So let me just go to, sorry, I meant to have this up. Okay, so Power Automate and Teams. All right, so in this Power Automate for Teams app, it's really easy for any user to create templates. Like there's templates that are available to you. They're very easy workflows, you know, very simple workflows that you can create from scratch. So we are going to be talking about some of these today. I'm just going to use, so for example, if you do a search out here, you know, there is a ton of information out here. If you just do a search for Teams, how to install that app, how to get started, how to create flows, how to manage them. There's just a plethora of information out there for you. So, you know, please search online, get yourselves familiar and just start from there. But that being said, what I'm going to do is I'm going to focus on just using some of the templates because really just getting started, I think the easiest way, and unless you're pretty proficient and you feel pretty good about using Power Automate or workflows and doing, you know, you've set up workflows in the past and, you know, you're comfortable with a level of complexity. For the most part, people that are just getting started, this isn't a hard thing, but the best place to start is with a template. And the templates that I'm going to show you today are actually going to be all based off of helping you to be more productive. So these are templates that already exist out there that, you know, I just picked a few of them that we're going to go through today that I just think are quick wins for absolutely everyone. So you can see here, I've got Power Automate up here and I have the ability, I see my home. So basically all of my flows are going to show up here. I have the ability to create, to chat. I have approvals, but actually there's an approvals app now. So technically you could really ignore that. Any business process flows I have, for the most part, honestly, I'm only going to really go between home and create here. All right, so when I go to create, what it does is it brings back start with a popular Teams template. You can look at top picks, approvals, buttons, calendar, email. We briefly talked about some of this on one of the past sessions, but again, this is specifically Power Automate with Teams. So, you know, we wanted to make this easy. So honestly, you know, you can do a keyword search if you want to pull back, like say I'm trying to trigger, you know, create a task from a message. Okay. So actually let's go ahead and just, let's do this one because this is an easy one. And creating a task from a message, what this is, right? So it's Planner really. And I think from a productivity standpoint, we've had a lot of, The reason why I think this is a great first showcase is because we've had a lot of business users that have really gravitated towards using Planner and absolutely love it, right? Because it is, honestly, it's a much easier to use project management tool than Project itself. And I'm saying this as even someone who, you know, is certified in Project and has experience with Project Online, but it's overwhelming for your average user. So Planner has been really popular. So really this is just, it's basically assigning my permissions here. So it's gonna use Microsoft Teams, it's gonna use Planner. I'm just gonna say continue. And now it's gonna say, let's go ahead and set up your flow. And you're kind of like, oh my gosh, I don't have this Planner group ID. Don't worry about that. Because see, you can see here from the dropdown, it's actually gonna give you all of your options here. So each of your teams. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna say, this is in the IT team. And this is my it's going to be posted to my Mark 8 project plan that I already have created. So again, this is for a plan or a plan that you already have set up. So I'm just going to go ahead and click create flow. Okay, it's been created. Now what you're going to do, and it does take like I don't know, like a minute, so let's just see if we can get it to work here. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to go into my IT team here. And I'm going to go into just this research and development. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hover over a message. So I've seen something that warrants, you know, creating a task in our Mark 8 project plan. So Deborah, let's see what Deborah's feedback here. I'm going to translate this. Okay, so challenge, she's creating a hybrid environment for a pilot program for their customers. You know what, that's great. Maybe we want to hear more about that. So great, it already provisioned. So you can see here, when I right click on this option, I'm going to do it again, just so it'll be quick when we do this next time. More actions, you can see here that I have options available to me. And one of them is that Power Automate that I just created, which is create a task from a message. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select that item. And I'm going to give this a title, you know, review, if I can spell, hybrid environment. And I can even give this a due date, meet by Deborah to review this tomorrow because it's time sensitive. So I'm going to go ahead and click that, click submit. Then I'm going to go ahead. You can see Power Automate already triggered. So I'm going to go ahead and go into my plan. And here's my review hybrid environment. So now I can go in here, I can add any necessary changes that I need to, I can assign it to someone, but basically you can see how easy this is. I can drag it into the appropriate bucket, wherever it may need to go, but very easy for me to just quickly add a task on the fly, you know, based off of that particular post. So very simple. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to go back to Power Automate. Oh, and just to show you what that looks like from chat here, the card. You can actually see. So here, right, planner task created successfully. So essentially it's just giving me a confirmation and then I can click view task, which will take me directly to the item in planner. So again, super simple, easy way to create tasks on the fly. So let's go ahead and let's create another one. Another, it's already up here. another popular item is OneNote. People love OneNote. So I thought that this would be another one that would be really great to show you because, you know, we all hoard our notebooks, right? Some of us live out of our notebooks. Like I live out of my notebook and I live out of Teams. So I think that this one's important because I know a lot of customers really love OneNote and it helps keep them organized throughout their day. It helps keep all their notes together. So I thought that this would be another great one. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just say, again, new flow. And again, I could have just selected that one. But again, if I'm just going to pretend like to search for, something, because I think this is, again, if you just search by keyword, if you don't want to go down all the categories, it's really easy. Just put in one keyword and pull back the template that you want to use. So again, I'm not worried about the flow name. This is what it is. And again, it's just validating the permissions and I'm creating my flow. Now you might be looking at this and you might be like, oh my goodness, okay, this is what am I looking at here? You don't need to change any of this. It literally is just, it's already been built for you, right? So again, this is what is actually gonna be pasted into your OneNote notebook. So this is a message from, right, what you're pulling out of Teams and in putting into your notebook. So this is who that message was from, it's the post details, it's any additional notes, and then a link actually to that message to be able to go back and jump to it and open it for more information if needed. So I'm just going to go ahead and create my flow. All right, it's been created. So again, it takes like, it didn't even take a minute the last time, but so I'm going to go ahead and go back to a team here. And here I'll select a different team. All right, so mock-up review, or here, I'll just take this blur message here. Oh, here we go, good. All right, so you can see here now another Power Automate was added, so you can see save message to OneNote. So I'm gonna go ahead and just click that, and I can add a note for additional context for this message, you know, pertains to Project X, and I can go ahead and submit that. Okay, and then we'll get a card validating. Oops, didn't mean to go there, I meant to go with the card. Okay, and then we're gonna go ahead and just say view note. So it's gonna open up my OneNote. And here we go. So message from Megan Bowen, save to Teams, message details, notes, link to message. So essentially, right, it created a new page, it dropped this in. Again, you can modify this, do anything with this. You can also, with these two templates that I've already shown you and how easy it is to just have this automation happen, you can build on top of the template, right? So the template isn't the end all be all. You can use that template and then build upon it, edit it. Very, very simple thing to do. So again, if you're proficient, make it do what you need it to do. All of the controls, the triggers, the actions, they're all there for you. And we'll look at that. We'll look at those last from a customization standpoint if we get time. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and go back again. And another popular one is this one. Notify a team when a new item is created. Not that one. Let's see if it is it there. Nope. Okay, so here. I want documents. Oops, new flow. Hold on. The wrong thing. Not my list. I'm going to search the templates. Okay, document. All right. Nope. That's not what I meant. I meant file. Okay. Notify a team when a file is added to SharePoint. This is the one I wanted specifically. So the reason why I brought this one up is because I feel like I've been talking to a lot of folks in marketing lately, and we've been talking about their document libraries and trying to notify the right people when documents have been added because it's updated collateral. So I feel like just have been having that conversation a lot. So I thought that this one would just be really great to highlight because it is nice to know when a file does get added into your team. So let's go ahead and trigger this flow. So this one is just Teams and SharePoint here, have the permissions. All right, so now what it's gonna ask you is it's gonna say SharePoint site address. Let's see, so in this one, what should I use? We'll say marketing. Okay, so in SharePoint marketing, and this is going to be documents. And then you can select a folder, right? So if I click this, you can select a folder or you can leave blank for the whole library. In this case, we're just going to leave blank, right? And then specifically inside of a team. Okay, so this is marketing. And in the Teams channel, we will say this is creative services, because that makes sense. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and create a flow. And the workflow has been created. So let's go ahead and go over to marketing. Let's see, oh, creative services. And we're going to go into files. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'll just go ahead and create a new document here. So we'll just pretend like this is a new design document. I'm obviously not going to create it, but I am creating it. But I'm going to go ahead and just close this out right away. Okay, and you can see here, here's my new design document that was just created a few seconds ago. And then hopefully the I gave it enough time for the Power Automate to pull through. There it is. Okay, good. I was going to say, I wanted to make sure. Okay, so update from SharePoint. So you can see here a new file was added. So this actually posted in the channel for Creative Services that, hey, there's a new file that was added. This is where the file is. Go click on it and view it. So really, really good when you have a library that has a heavy hand for users that are needing those documents and need to understand when new documents are getting added. You can obviously also trigger flows for when documents get updated. So even if there's if you have SharePoint lists, you'll find when you go back and you look at the templates, there's SharePoint lists as well. All right, so last one, because we are at the end of time here. So let's talk about, how about this one? How about getting a Teams message when you receive an email? Some of us are trying to live inside of Teams, but some people are still living in email. But so maybe now for this one, what we want to do is we want to create a new flow and we want to send a message to Teams when we're receiving an email. So let me just go ahead and search for email really quick. Okay, send a Teams message when receiving an email, this one. All right, so I'm gonna let it do its permission checks. All right, so here's my recipient. So in this case, so this is going to be Adele. And create my flow. And my workflow has been created. All right, so if I go over to Adele here, can we schedule some time to meet? And by the way, there's even one in there for actually creating a meeting as well. So just FYI. All right, so I know we are one past time here. I always feel like I'm never allowing time for Q&A, and I sincerely apologize. So I hope Scott's been keeping up with that. I hope he's been keeping up with that in terms of answering your individual questions. If not, I promise we will follow up. Please don't hesitate to reach out. And then you'll see here it will actually come through eventually. It may just be taking a second, kind of like the others. But just know that the notification will come through. Essentially, it's going to notify me via the Power Automate. Again, so just like you're seeing here, it's going to notify me on the emails as well. So you can actually see one up here earlier from when I did this important email task from Adele. And it even is attaching sediment. So Mod, I'd like you to propose options for task management within our team. And then obviously, right, I could even do more actions from this in terms of creating a work item for myself. So again, those are just a few ways that, you can, be more proficient in your day, and automate your day and just very easy flows for you to start getting your hands wet with. So again, apologies. I know I'm out of time here, but again, we thank you so much for your time today. Please take a look at the trythisat.work website for the additional upcoming events that I mentioned at the beginning of the call. If you didn't hear about those, please do go to the trythisat.work site and you will see all the upcoming events. There's going to be some really great sessions. So with that, I thank you so much, everyone, for your time today. And again, all events will be posted on demand on the trythisat.work site. So please, in case anyone missed it, just let them know it will be posted shortly. With that, we thank you so much, everyone, and we hope you have a great day.